Hello children, how are you all? I hope you are happy and healthy. As you all know, we are learning writings, how to write letters. So in this series we have talked about formal letters, how to write formal letters. And as you all know, these are the letters to whom we are writing, to whom those who are not in our very close relative, our friends and our colleagues. We are writing these letters in the very formal way, in a very concise way, very direct way, very simple way to the authorities. In the series of that formal writing, we are going to learn today application writing. This you can say is a very short type of letters. We are writing to whom? With them are formal relationship. So they are called applications. We are requesting something to that particular authority. So that is why we are writing these type of the short letters. These are all called applications. So now let's see the definition of application. An application is a letter of formal request that we write to people with whom we have formal relationship. So this you always keep in your mind whenever you are writing an application. So you are applying for anything. That is why you are writing application. And you are writing application to whom? Those who are not very close to you. Those who are not, you can say, your relationship is not informal, your relationship with them formal. That is why you are writing in a very formal way and it's having a format also. So let's discuss about the format of application writing. So as we have discussed in our last video, formal letters. So the whole format is the same, but because this is not a letter, this is, you can say, the very short type of the letter, and this is called application. So you just write in a very concise way. You should be very particular about your subject. So it is a form of letter, but very short. So this you always keep in your mind. So now let's start discussing the format of application writing. So the format of application writing is, first of all, we should write at the left of the corner, top of the corner, you will write recipient address. Recipient address means to whom you are writing this application, to whom you are writing. That you are going to write the address of that particular person or authority. So this you always keep in mind whenever you are starting your application. Then you are supposed to write at the left of the corner the recipient address. So now let us discuss and start writing the format of application writing. So first of all, you should always remember, whenever we are writing an application, we should write at the left of the corner recipient address. So now let's start writing recipient address. Recipient address will be there. First of all, at the left of the corner, it means to whom you are writing your application. Now next is date. After writing the address and the name of that particular recipient that you are requesting for something, so after that you just leave one line and then write date. Date should be mentioned in a very direct way. You cannot put slash over there, or you cannot write 1st September. This type of the things will not be considered in the application writing. So always write 2nd September 2020. This you are going to write. So this way you can write the date. And after that you just leave one line and then subject. On which subject you are writing your application. What is your subject? Suppose if you are requesting someone for the sick leave application. So always remember, you should mention over here which type of the leave you are applying an application. So subject must be mentioned over here, and after that you will write the third topic of application writing is body of the letter. After writing this, you will start salutation. Salutation must be there because you are addressing to whom you are writing. So that is very important. Salutation in every letter, it is very important because you have to be address that particular person to whom you are writing a letter. So in application also you have to be mention over here salutation, dear sir, dear madam, these type of the things would be there. Now after that you just start writing your body of the letter. Body of the letter. In this you will start with I would like to inform you, I would like to ask you, these type of the introductory line you should be give. So this is very important. Whenever you are writing an application, you should be very particular. You should show respect first of all, because you are writing to the authorities. You are not writing this type of the application to your friends or colleagues or family members. So that you always be remember whenever you are writing an application to your principal, to your manager, to editor, to anyone. So that you always keep in your mind, you are talking with the authority to whom we are having very formal relationship. We are not very close in relation. So that is why salutation must be there. And then whenever you are writing about the body of the letter, you will start with I would like to inform you. This type of the things will be mentioned over there. So because these are the very formal language. So this language should be in a very simple and very humbly you will start. Because if you are requesting for something, so you should be very humble about that. And you should be show your gratitude at the end of the body of the letter. Whenever you are concluding this application, you have to be show your gratitude. I shall be highly obliged, or I will be grateful to you. So these type of the sentences should be mentioned at the end of the body of the letter or body of an application. So that you always keep in your mind. Whenever you are writing an application, you should be start your body of your application with a very humble request. And then you just continue your things, whatever you are informing or you are requesting. So the cause should be there why you are asking these type of the leave, why you are going outside station, why you are having some problem. So that should be mentioned over there. The cause will be mentioned over there. Then you will just inform that this to this date, I will be unavailable in this institution. So this type of the thing should be mentioned over there. So only 4 or 5 lines you can conclude your application. So main thing, you should start with the very humble request. Then you go, then you will go with the your causes, why you are not present these days. So what problem you are facing, that you just mention. And why you are writing this application, that you always mention over there. So these are the things that body of the of an application is a very important thing. Because you are writing on that subject. The subject should be mentioned inside. Why you are writing an application? Because your subject is sick leave. Suppose, I am just giving you an example. So this is a subject. On this subject, you are writing your sick leave application. And you are writing a sick leave application. So that sick, your sickness, your illness should be mentioned over here, inside this body of your application. So this you always keep in mind. Whenever you are starting your body of an application, you just be very humble about that, and then gradually you will go to the cause, and then you just give your reasons, and then you just asking a leave or anything else, and then in the concluding line you should be mention that I'll be highly obliged, or you can write I will be grateful to you. So these type of the language you will use in this application writing. Now after concluding line, first of all you start your I would like to inform you that I am suffering from fever since this to this date. So that you should mention, and then you are just asking your leave, and then you at the end of the body of the letter you can write I would be grateful to you. I would be grateful to you that you are going to write whenever you are concluding your body of the letter. Then the most important part is after body, it's subscription. Subscription means here you are ending your letter, so you have to be mentioned yours obediently, yours faithfully, yours sincerely. So these type of the things you will mention, because you are students, so that is why your obediently you can write, or your faithfully you can write, sincerely, your sincerely. So these type of the things you will be going to write over here. Yours obediently will write. So in subscription, this is very important. Whenever you are writing an application, first of all, recipient address, you are writing to your principal. So to the principal, whatever your school's name, you will write, and then you can write the address also over there. After leaving one line, you will write date, and then subject must be mentioned over there. Then salutation, then body of the letter, then subscription. This is very important. Now after subscription, what you are going to write? You have to be your signature, your name should be mentioned. Name, signature, and if you are having any designation, so that you are going to mention over here. You should mention date also. You should mention your class also. So date you have already mentioned. Sorry for that. But you should have mention your class, section, and all the things. So this is the format of an application. You just go through this and you just learn how to write an application. Then we are going to start writing an application. Now before going to start write an application, we should discuss about the features of an application. So first of all, as we have discussed, form of formal letter. This is a form of formal letter. It is, you can say, it is a type of formal letter, but it is written in a very short way. And now next thing, the language and tone of the letter are very formal. We should use very formal language and tone, and very short language. We are not going to use any flowery sentences over here. we should use very formal language, and we should conclude each and everything in a few lines. We are not going to write in detail everything. So that you always keep in mind, because whenever you are writing an application, you should be very concise. Your words should be, your sentence should be very concise. Now next thing, address should be given. Recipient address should be given. Suppose you are writing to your principal an application, so you should write the principal, Army Public School, Varanasi, Kent 39 GTC. The address should be mentioned over there. And then subject should be mentioned before salutation. That you always keep in your mind. Whenever you are writing an application, subject should be mentioned before salutation. Whenever you are going to address to the principal or to the editor or anyone, the subject should be there. On which subject, on which topic you are writing an application, that should be mentioned over here. Now, the recipient's address, either by sir, madam, or dear sir or dear madam. Whenever you are giving your salutation, you should be very particular about sir or madam. And if it is required, you can write dear sir or dear madam. It is based on their gender. So in general, we can use sir. Now, sixth point is body. Body of your application should clear, concise, and relevant to the point. We are not discussing, we are not talking about anything. We just writing an application about what we want. Only that topic we are going to write over there. None other topic. So always be very, very relevant, and your topic or your body should clear and relevant and to the point. We are not going to talk over here. We are not going to write the anything else. You just be very particular about the topic. On which topic you are writing your application and what is your subject. So you should go through this very clear, concise, and in a very short sentences you will write an application. So these are the features of an application. So this is, if you always remember, so you will never get confused in the formal letter or application. So an application is a short form of formal letters. Formal letter, we can write more words, more sentences, but in an application you should be very concise. In a very short way you should mention or you should request anything. So this you always keep in your mind. Now let's start writing. I am going to write some questions on the board, so we will complete the answers, or you can say we are going to write an application on that. So let's start writing an application. So write an application to your principal, seeking permission for what? Seeking permission to avail the school transport facility for a week. So this is your application. You writing on that. this is your request. So just write down this question. Write an application to your principal seeking permission to avail the school transport facility for a week. So on this, we are going to write an application. So take a screenshot. So first of all, what we are going to write? We are going to write at the left of the corner, the principal. So one thing I would like to say, once again, the principal, whenever you are writing principal, your P must be capital. So many of the children, whenever we are going through your copies, you are writing P always small. Because you are thinking, because we are writing the over here big. T is in a capital letter. So there is no way to write P capital. So always remember, whenever you are writing an application, the P should be capital over there. So to the principal, and then whenever you are writing army, because you are studying in army public school, so always remember army A will be capital, and then public P will be capital, and school. So many of the children are doing that. Army you will write in capital, and school and public you will write in small. So it is very, very wrong. So always remember, whenever you are writing any institution name, the first letter of any word should be capital. So Army Public School 39 GTC Kent Varanasi. Varanasi. So this you will write in a proper way. So C will be capital, and Varanasi V will be capital. So don't do any mistake writing the address of recipient. So always remember this. Now after that, leaving one line, you just write down date. Today is 2nd September. So we are writing over here 2nd September 2020. So here you can see no any punctuation marks, no comma, nothing else, no slashes. Always remember, whenever you are writing the date in the application, the date should be mentioned like this. First the date, and then month, and then year should be mentioned. So this you always keep in your mind. Then we are proceeding in the application. So subject, after leaving one line, subject will be mentioned. Subject will be mentioned over here. What is the subject? Request for permission to avail school transport facility for a week. Facility for a week. So this is your topic. So always remember, the topic should be mentioned in a very clear way. Whenever your principal will read your application, so he or she must be confirmed that on which topic you are writing an application. So your subject should be mentioned over there. Okay. So first of all, what we have done? Recipient addressed, and then leave one line, then date will be there, and then leave one line, then subject will be there. Subject should be clear what you are asking for, but or on which topic you are requesting. That should be mentioned very, very clear way. So that you always keep in your mind whenever you are writing an application. Now, after that, subject, you just leave one line and then write down, dear madam. Dear madam, and after that, you are going to start writing your body of your application. I would like to state that, due to leg injury, I have been advised, by the doctor, to avoid, walking for a week. Now, however, so now here the time space is less, so after writing this, you just write down first, then I'm going to erase this, then we will write more. So take a screenshot. Now, however, after however, we are going to write over here. However, my unit tests are due. Are due next week. So, and I am unwilling. To miss my school. I will be, now here you can write, I will be grateful, if you kindly permit or grant me the permission, to avail school transport facility for a week, because you are asking for a week, because you won't be able to walk. That is why you are writing an application for that. So, for a week, from 3rd September, from 3rd September 2022, 9th September 2020. So you have mentioned over here from which date to which date you want the transport facility of a school. Now you are going to write the subscription part. Your obediently, yours obediently, write your name and class. Write your name and class. So this way you can write an application to your principal to avail transport facility for a week. School transport facility for a week. You just write down this. And take a screenshot. So in the next video, we will practice more about an application. And we will continue some writings in that also. So till then, keep practicing these type of the writings because these are very important formal letters. Practice it at your home and be safe and healthy. That's all for today. Bye-bye and take care.